Hi, I'm Lynn from How To Heroes, and we're here with Dick and Sue Viera, master ice fishermen. We're at Lake Rico in Massasoit State Park in East Taunton, Massachusetts, where I grew up. And we're going to teach you how to, instead of hibernating during the winter, get out and embrace the elements and ice fish and learn how this is not a cooking utensil.
We're out here at Lake Rico today. I'm just giving you a rundown of how we get started ice fishing. Cutting the holes. I have a 10-inch auger here, makes it a little bit easier. We cut 10 holes, 5 traps per person, so we can cut as many holes as we want, but we have 10 traps. When I'm cutting through the ice, you can feel as you go through, you get to the edge of the thickness of the ice, the pressure, you'll feel the pressure release on the machine, and you'll feel it plunge through the ice. So I go out and drill the holes first, clean out the holes, and set them up. Today we got about 17 inches of ice, which is perfect. And then Sue comes behind me and sets the traps.
So now I'm gonna set the trap. This is how a trap is when you first get it out. You have it all folded up. So you just wanna open it up, and you've got these little nuts here to tighten it into place. So the first thing I'm going to do is test the depth of the water with this weight. So I put the weight on the hook. These are number 2 hooks, which the smaller the number, the larger the hook. So I just slowly let this out. Until it hits the bottom, you can see it stopped spooling. So I'll mark where the water line is. And then I want to go maybe 6 inches beyond that, and I'll move this button as my marker. So now what I've done is I've set the weight 6 inches above the bottom of the floor. That way when we put our bait in, it's swimming above the bottom and it's not in the weeds. So that's how you test your depth. So now it's all set to put the shiner on. Today we're using shiners. Sometimes we use chubs. Shiners are freshwater. They're not quite as hardy. Chubs are saltwater. They're really hardy. They'll last for weeks. This is a shiner. You can see, you know, they're a little bit whiter on their belly. They're also kind of thin, like narrow. They have flat sides and they're freshwater. This is a chub. This is a real small one, but they do get real big. They're slippery and they're a little bit, they're wider on their top. They're a little bit fatter. So you can kind of tell the difference. And you can see their mouth is a bit hardier. Shiners have really thin mouths, so we bait them through the back. That way the hook doesn't tear out. So then you've got your weight here and your shiner. You just drop them in and slowly let the line out until you hit the button. So you can see on the spool you have this little hook that keeps the line from going out. So you just kind of set the button, and then the final step is to set the flag. So the flag comes up, you hook it up here, and you can see how it's connected to this line, this long piece right here. So when the fish grabs the bait and takes it, it turns that, which sets the flag off. So I'll just reset that, drop it in, and we wait. We'll give it about 20 minutes, then we'll come around, check all the holes. We'll also pull out the trap, check on the shiner, make sure he's still swimming around, just making sure the traps are good, and we'll get a fish if he comes by. So while we're waiting for the traps, we like to cook up some linguica, some hot dogs, we've got some marinated pork. It's always a good thing to have while you're waiting out on the ice.
Hey. flag. Go get it, go get it, somebody get it.
Oh, he's taking it. He's taking it. Oh, I lost him. I think I lost him. Because sometimes when you set it, you pull the fish out. You pull the bait out of his mouth. I think I do have him though. He's just under the ice.
Wow, look! Dick, already!
He ain't taking it, he ain't taking it. There he goes. He's on there.
Got him? Nice. Another pickerel. Want to feed him the shiner?
Yeah. No, because you're going to get... Yeah, you know, the birds will eat it.
Okay.
Ready? I'm going to throw him back in. Just now you get the seagull coming. He's going to come right up to us. He's going to eat that.
Yeah, that was a nice fat pickerel. And it was good. Sometimes the pickerel tend to swallow them for some reason. Because if they do swallow it, you could actually kill the fish by trying to pull the hook out of its throat. So instead, we'll just cut the line, let the fish live, and the hook will rot out after, you know, so many months. Because we're not here to kill. We're just here to have fun on a nice day.